This edition of Computer Club Lesson was recorded on March the 13th, 2017. Today we talk about email on the web. Hello, welcome to Computer Club Lesson. This episode is brought to you by the Binary Guys. Okay, good afternoon, folks. It's after 1 o'clock again. We're a little late because we're doing stuff before the class. I'll just mention that for this. Today, we want to dive into online email a little bit further than we have in the past. So James is going to look at Gmail, but I am going to look at Outlook Mail, Outlook.com, mainly because I've had a couple of questions over the last little while on how to do things in Outlook, and I don't use Outlook, so I didn't know how to do them. So over the last couple of weeks, I have done a little bit in Outlook, looking around and finding ways to use Outlook for those people that need a few questions answered. Now, I have no mail in this because I am forwarding all mail from this account to my Gmail account. So if there was anything that came through here, James is going to see it a little while later. But what we want to look at mainly is the inbox, the sent items. I don't think there's anything there. No, there's not. And you can archive mail from here. When you start to use Outlook, if I had a piece of mail in here, I would click on the mail, and then other things would appear here across the top. Things like forward, reply, reply all, and all of that would be there. And to move mail, to another folder that you've made, or to move it to the trash. And all of that will appear right here alongside of new mail. New mail as a drop down with this little arrow right beside the word new gives you more commands, so you can start a new email message, or you can launch a calendar and put an event in there. Now, Outlook Mail, if you're using it all the time and people send you calendar events from Outlook Mail in the Outlook suite, okay, they will be those calendar events, this web page will be able to pick up and put them on your calendar if you accept them as an event. Okay, so if someone sends you to go to dinner in 2 weeks, okay, and as soon as you accept, it will go on to your calendar as an accepted event, and you'll be able to view it in your calendar from there. Let's click on new email message. And here again, across the top, it gives you some more items to do when you're setting up a message to send. And it has an easy way to look at how to format your email message. The formatting of the text, the size, the color, indentations, and all of that stuff is available for you here, more so here and easier to get at than something like Gmail. Gmail is pretty much a stripped down version of a text editor, but it's good enough to get your text to your friends. you can make this look pretty. That's the whole idea, to make it look pretty. The other thing that you can do when you have a send message open is that you can add media from anywhere else that you want. So I'm just going to send this to the bottom for a second, and I'm going to open up my pictures folder and see if I can find something there. Pictures. There's that screenshot I had before. Now I can do a few things with this. Now that I've got it up, I can open the email, open the web page again, bring this to the front by just clicking on the folder, and I should be able to just drag this picture to there. Okay, and it loaded the picture in the email. Where'd it go?
You accidentally closed the erase drafts.
Oh, you're right. Oopsie doodles. Well, where did the attachment go?
So you click draft. No subject, no.
Yeah, I was going to say, I can tell you from experience, you've lost it and start again.
All right.
No, it's right here. Literally, this is it. Click this.
All right, there it is.
Ta-da.
Sorry about that. Ta-da. There you go. Thank you.
See,
I told you, I don't use Outlook Mail. I don't know very much about it. He knows a lot about it. He doesn't use it either.
But he knows it.
But he knows it.
I mean, I use it for some things.
Can I ask what you clicked? Because when I look back and I end up with drafts, I lose things. Where would anyone do that?
Well, draft is just the saved version of, like, before you send it.
Yeah, before you send it.
It's just the same version, like, hey, you accidentally closed this.
You stop typing for like about 10 seconds, it's gone to drafts.
Yeah, exactly so. Okay. Exactly so.
Because it hasn't vanished, but then I can never get the picture back.
You just
that's what James was saying here. Okay, there's, if you click on the drafts folder, it's showing you that there is one draft item here, and I didn't put a subject in it, but it's showing you that it's there.
So you just click that, and it will open up the email again.
Yeah, it will open this up.
Yeah, mine does as, without a picture.
Now, how did you do it?
Wrong, obviously.
Because if you do, I'm going to take this one out. Okay, there it is, it's gone. And I'm going to attach it with the paperclip. Okay, so I know that this file is on my computer, and I know that it's in, where is it at?
Right above 192.168.2.14.
Yep, there we go. There's the picture again. So I've navigated to it and clicked on it. This is the picture I want, and it's put it in the all files box. And when I say open, it should send this.
So that's
yeah, attach as a copy. Okay, so there we go. It's put it in the body of the email message. Okay, you're using Outlook, right?
Yes.
Okay. That's the way it should work. That's the way it's supposed to work. The other way to do it, like I said, is to bring up the file folder with your picture in it, with the picture that you want.
Off the screen. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Then open pictures and drag it over, and that always works so long as I keep going and send it. If I stop and it goes to...
Yeah, so long, if you stop and try and do something else, it sends it to drafts.
Yeah. And it never seems to open it again.
It should do by just simply clicking on that line. When you click on drafts over here on the left, you'll see the line where it is.
Yeah.
Let me just go to inbox here. And okay, now I'm going to go to drafts again. Now you see what happened is it didn't highlight that line. So if it's not highlighted, perhaps you're thinking to yourself it's not there. Could be. You, if you go over here and you highlight that line, now you know that there it is. Okay?
And you can edit it.
Yeah. Where have we gone here? Okay, here's, so we can edit this again with the little pencil over here on the right-hand side of the screen. There's a little pencil over there. That's the icon for edit. You have a pencil in your hand, you edit, okay? And so there it is. What that was showing you before was how the picture will look in the email that someone else receives. Once the sender or once the receiver gets it, that's how it will look with the picture in line. I told you about in line last week. If it's in the body of the email, it's in line. Okay? That's how the receiver would see the item. Let's go back to drafts here. Yeah. Yeah, exactly so. So I'm going to try again here.
So if I just touch it, it
yeah.
Be there.
All right, so now our from line is already filled in. You can do with that as you please. The to line, if we just if we click on the word to, it's going to open up the contact list that I have in the computer, and you can go to your contacts from there. The other way to do it is to just start typing. Okay, so if I just start typing, it's going to give me James's email address, a friend of mine, James Lawson. So they're in there. You just pick the one you want. And off it will go. Now, I have not put a subject line in here yet. I'm just going to put in test pick. And we haven't sent this yet. So let's say I'm going to go and do something else. I'm in the inbox now. I'm doing something else. Go back to drafts. And now I've got a name of the guy I'm sending it to. Okay. And that there's the name of the email is test pick. And there's no message in the text yet. But if I click on it, there it is. Okay, so we're back here. It's all good.
Then you're down to send.
Well, I'm not going to send this. I'm going to make it all go away because James will. Well, the other thing here is I may as well get into this as well. Where you can start editing text and what it's going to look like. In Outlook, you've got all kinds of things that you can do to text. I'm just going to put some random text in there. You've got all kinds of things you can do with it. You can make it bigger. Where is make
the first one.
Make it bigger?
No, sorry.
That's the kind.
Oh, please make it Comic Sans. I want to piss off everyone.
Oh yeah. Okay, it's the second one, so
please.
We can make it bigger. That's 20. We can change its color or part of its color. So I can say I want it to be red now. Yeah. See, all of these things to make it pretty, and you can. Center justify, left justify, right justify. All of the justifies are there to make a really nice email. Now, let's just simply get rid of this. Go back to drafts. And I can say empty folder. I don't want this anymore. Okay, so that all of that work is gone. It's Gonski. The reason I did that is I want to go back to the contact list. Okay, and in Outlook Mail, the contact list is essentially its people. And how do you get your contact list?
When I throw up the email, and you know where it says, you know, BC, I click on BC, and the little line is there, and I click the first letter, and the name comes up, and that's that.
Yeah, okay. You should be seeing this.
No, I don't have that black line. It's not like you could miss that.
I mean, he probably hasn't said so it's a black line.
No.
There are, I'll have to, you've got the strangest damn computer. I set it all up for you and it just went crazy over the last couple of years. Let's get away from that. The one thing that someone asked me about, and I believe it was Ruth, was how to make a special contact list for special people that you're doing special mailings to. Okay. In my contact, I've got all my contacts here. These are all my Google contacts, by the way. These are not my regular contacts. These are not my Skype contacts. These are my Google contacts. I've done that so as I can show you how to import contacts into Microsoft Outlook. In any event, what we want to do to make a special mailing list is we're going to make new, and we're going to make new a contact list. Now we give the list a name, okay? And I'm just going to say Computer Club. Right, and at this point I start to add members. Okay, so I'm going to add James.
The name doesn't start with
a name. Oh, that's why I didn't find it. Okay, so James, just click on his name, and he's now a member. I want another one. Okay, I'll go for my wife. And there's her email address. And you can just that simply, you can put that many names in. You're putting them in by hand. You're not, you have to get them into contacts first. And then you can build a special list. You can't build this special list without having a contact list to begin with. This is special.
Do they go out alphabetically once you get them in there?
Yes, they do. And the other thing is now I'm going to say, well, I'm done with this, so I'm going to save it. I could put 40, 50 people in there, but I'm going to save it right now. If I go looking, if I go looking for that special contact list, I've got it there. Now, just do a new mail. And I'm going to do a new email. Oops. And if I just start typing, I know that the contact list name is Computer Club. So if I just start typing computer, it's going to put it there. So I've got another entry here for Computer Club. Or for computers, I don't know why I didn't find it. This worked before.
Probably because it would have to be a CC. Because it's multiple people.
Yeah, maybe so. So let's try a CC. Nope, not there. Oh, search. Search people. Computer Club, you're right, there it was. There's our Computer Club. I'm going to click on this. Now, if I double click on this to see what's what, if I click on the plus sign in front of Computer Club, it shows me everybody that's in the list. Okay? It shows me everybody that's in the list. There's only two, but there could be 50. I am going to make these go away, and under the two, I am going to try again. Search people. No match is found. There it is, Computer Club. Got to be careful about what I'm doing. Okay. So there it is. It's in the two line. We could put it in the CC line and one name only in the two line. Or I could send it to myself in the two line and then put everybody else in the CC line. That's one way to do it if you're making a large list. So that's making a special list in Outlook Mail. I'm going to make this draft go away. Now, let's go back to people here, and I want to, this is my Google contacts, but I want to have this list, this Google contacts list, in my bare bones contact list for mail, because I might want to delete that Google contacts list somewhere in the future, so as I don't get confused. So I can manage this contacts list by hitting the drop down, and I can import the contacts from a place that I have already exported them to. I've already put this on my desktop, so I know that this list is from Gmail. No. Windows Live Mail, that's right. Now I can browse to where they are. I know it's on the desktop because I put it there yesterday. Where did I put it? Well, isn't that strange, strange, strange? Well, I know it was there.
Your desktop, maybe it's there.
I know what I did wrong. Let's go back to Google Contacts. And I'm going to manage them by exporting the contacts. Okay? So I'm going to export them all, and I'm going to export them as a Microsoft Outlook CSV. We've talked about this before. Comma separated value. Okay? And I'm going to export the contacts from the Google contacts, because that's where they all are. I'm getting the contacts out of Google contacts and I'm putting them into the contacts folder. Okay? They're two separate things. So now, I'm going to go ahead and tell this to export. And it's going to go to contacts and it's going to go to desktop. And I save it. And it's Gonski. It's there now. So let's go back to contacts. We have nothing there but our computer club. Okay. And I'm going to import. I'm going to import contacts into the contact list. And here again, I'm going to use where I got them from, an email client already on the computer. So I'm going to browse this. I'm going to go to desktop. And there it is, contacts, CSV. Okay, and we'll tell it to open. And we'll tell it to upload. That's what it's doing. It's going from this local computer here up to the internet. Okay? That's where it's going. And when it's done that, the import is successful. I should be able to now look at my Google contacts. And yes, there's all my Google contacts. And when I look at the contacts in the contacts folder for Outlook People, there they all are. So that's how you export a contact list from Outlook Mail and how you import a contact list into Outlook Mail, as well as making a special folder of contacts. That's pretty much everything I can tell you about this. Yes?
Okay. I have Outlook Mail, but mine is on an app.
Right.
I would rather have it on the program. So would I?
Well, this is not a program. This is the web. This is not an app. This is a web page.
Okay, a web page.
Yeah.
So how do I get the web page? I just go to Outlook.com?
Yeah, and sign in.
Okay, and sign in. Mine is cakeboss@live.com.
Yeah, it will do that. It will do that. Put your
Your
live mail is IMAP.
Yeah.
Okay. As soon as you activate the program, or not the program, the web page for Outlook.com, it's going to look at all of the mail that you have in that email address. Okay? So you can start using it like this. Now, if you can also, and I'm going to do this. You should have an app here for people.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
And I'm going to find mine. Okay, there's the app for people.
Yeah.
And from here, you should be able to, Outlook.com should find this app for people with everything you have in it and just use it.
Yeah. Go to Outlook.com.
You won't have to import your addresses if you're already using them in the app.
Yeah. But that's what I'm saying. So if I just go to Outlook.com, and then do I have to download that or anything?
No, no. You're going to a web page.
Okay.
You're going to a web page.
All right.
As you would have done years ago with Hotmail.
Right.
It's exactly the same
right.
thing.
Right.
Only a new name.
When I got the computer, I didn't even know what the difference were the apps.
Yeah.
Pages.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Here again, the app that you're looking at right here is a it's a local thing.
Yeah.
It's local to this computer, but the information, the addresses, the people is already on the internet. It's already up in the cloud. When you open this app, all you're doing is just all of a sudden downloading it to here so you can see it, but it's still being manipulated in the cloud. You can When you make one go away, it goes away there. When you edit one, it's being edited in real time on the cloud, not locally. The app is just local, that's all. Yes?
So when, say you go on holiday, free Wi-Fi, is that what it is? I can type in hotmail.com and open my, or outlook.com?
Yes, and open your email from any computer on the planet. Yeah,
how do you close it then and not leave it open for the people?
Well, first off, if you're using a new computer to if you're using a new computer to look at your mail, something you've never used before, the computer should and will ask you, do you want a safe password for this? Don't touch it. Say no, but don't touch it. Or say never. The little box will come up on the top. Say
never.
Never. Okay. Then when you're done, make sure that you go here to you and you sign out. Right. If not, the cookie will be available for anybody else to use while that this computer is still up and running.
That's what I meant. I sign out.
You sign out.
It's not sitting anywhere else.
No, no.
Oh.
Once you've signed out, no one else can get in behind you unless they know your password.
Oh.
Right. Any other questions about Outlook Mail? No. You can use Outlook.com with any email address that you may have. Okay? Now, to do that, you have to make a new account with that email address. Okay? You have to make it in Outlook.com. Once that's done, then the mail will start flowing to Outlook.com from Source Cable, Rogers.net, Bell.net, anything. See, this is Bell.net that I'm using here. Okay. In Outlook.com, it's Bell.net. Okay. So I told Outlook.com I want to make an email address, and this is the address I want to use. Once I've made that account, there it is, forever.
Can you do that with Yahoo?
You should be able to. I'm not sure, you'd have to look it up, but I wouldn't want to go down that road, Brandon, and I'll tell you why. Because Yahoo right now is very unstable because they don't know what they're going to do with the company. So if you have a Yahoo address and you can get at it through Yahoo, keep using it that way. I'm not sure whether they will keep up with the whole idea of having cross-platform for Yahoo Mail. Okay? I'm not sure whether they'll keep it up. Okay, so that's pretty much Outlook Mail, unless there's any more questions here about it. I'm going to give James some time, about 20-25 minutes, if he needs it, to do Gmail. He's volunteered his services for Gmail. And so I will just bring up my Gmail account. All right. Tag, James. You're up.
I think I'm up.
You're up.
I'm not sure. I'm tired.
All right. So Gmail is what I use, well, what we use the most, because we just like Google. I was going to use my account, but for the life of me, I can't remember my password. So I'm using his. So when you first start up Google, you'll have pretty much three things in boxes. You'll have primary, promotions, and updates. You won't have social. He added that one. But all your mail that is sent to you will go into primary. And if you did sign up to like newsletters from websites or whatnot, they'll go in either updates or promotions. And promotions are what they sound. Hey, we have sales on. You want to buy something? So these are all separate. They won't all be in here. So you'll have to go into each one and empty them if you want to. But with contacts, it used to be just inside, but now if you go to Gmail and go to contacts, it will bring up a new web page of Google contacts, and in here you can create a label and name this label. We'll call it C Club. And now, if I want to actually add things into this label, I can just go over their name and say, oh yeah, I want, let's get emails in here. We'll get my mother. Oh, we'll get a guy we work for. And that person, and then up here on the top, you will have managed labels. So we click that, and we add them to the C Club. Now, I should open up my C Club. Open, thank you. And now everyone that's in the computer club is in here. This is how you make those special contact lists, like Outlook. It's just called labels in here. With that, let me go back to thing. So now if I compose an email, I can do two. There we go. So, normally you start out here, and if you click these arrows, you can pick where you want to go. So I want C Club. And I didn't pick a lot of people with emails, so there were three people, but two of them didn't have emails with them. So I can just say, yes, I want all these people in this computer club that I have made. And I want them to go into two. So I can send them all a letter. I don't have to go rooting through my contacts of who's computer club, who's not. And we can, again, bold text, italic text, underline the text, change the color, size, good old Arial thing, or what, it font?
Please don't change it.
Let me just change it to Comic Sans. Indentations, you can add bullets, so if you really want to be things. You can add bullets to everything. Same thing, you can add pictures either through attach files, dragging them over, or insert a photo. Again, you just have to go there. So I just want, I know there's pictures in presentation. Here, let's send this picture. Okay, so now that's an attached file down here.
And if you remember from the last time we were here a couple of weeks ago, I was able to take a photo from that folder and just drag it over into the body of the text.
Yeah.
And it showed up there.
I just didn't feel like opening up another window. And as we can see here, it's saved itself in drafts already. It will save pretty much like every 30 seconds after you type something. Just in case your computer goes off or you accidentally close the program, you didn't lose that paragraph that you just wrote. But with Gmail as well, I don't know if you can do it in Outlook. We'll just close that. You can organize your photos. Now, organize your emails. Now, he doesn't have any emails here, but what's with you and not having emails, man? At least I have like 5 in mine constantly.
Are you talking about making folders?
Yeah.
Okay. I've made a bunch already.
Okay, fine. So, he has a bunch already. From Bell, Binary Guys, family members. And you can make more by just, I think it's just more and then, right click? Oh. I don't see them make more. Oh, there it is. Yep, so we create a new label. We'll call this something stupid. We'll call it Dividend. There we go. And if I had emails that weren't already organized, I could put them in here. But he don't have emails that I can move. But I can still show you. So we'll just move Google Play here. Oops, put that back. So, once you've picked a email that you want to move by checkmarking it, you can hit move to, and then find the folder that you want. So,
the one you just made is up there.
Oh yeah, right. So now I moved it over there. Have fun with that. And now it's over here, and this made up one I just made up. You can do that with every email. I have it so every computer club video has its own separate folder, and all, and I don't open them. I was here. I know how it went. So I just move them over. So they're all not clogging up my inbox. But I can still get to them whenever I want, and they're organized.
How long should we keep these? I have everyone made on one folder, and I title them to give you a rough idea if I want to look at them.
If you're keeping them in Outlook,
yeah,
you can keep them forever.
So they're not, I mean, half an hour of this, it doesn't take up a lot of room.
No, it doesn't take up a lot of space. Number one, because it's only a link to the video. It's not the video itself. So it's just a line of text.
Oh, I thought it was the whole video and everything.
No. It's only a link.
Oh, okay. But my invaders are all out of the
computer. And even with Gmail, you can have hundreds, if not thousands, of emails just sitting there, because I don't know how many you have in terms of numbers, but he's only using 10% of 15 gigs. So, so he can have many, many Twitter alone.
Let us just say that I didn't have a life.
Have a life? What?
And I filled up my Gmail to 14 gigs. Okay? You know what Gmail would do? Give me 15 more.
Keep playing with my
product. Yeah, keep playing with my product. Exactly.
Yes.
Yep. I think they'll go all the way to a terabyte if you really have
one. I don't know about that, but they'll give me another 15 gigs if I get close.
Either that, worst case scenario, you just make another account.
No. As far as a size limit to your account, I believe there's like a 3 or 5 gig limit in Outlook.com but here again, don't worry about it because you're not saving these videos. You're just saving a text link.
Yeah.
If you look at the size of that email, it's probably something on the order of like
8 kilobytes.
400 kilobytes, something like that. The minimum of a picture now is 2 megabytes, okay? That picture is like 1,600 times bigger than 4 kilobytes or 400 kilobytes. So it's not much at all when you look at it as how much room is taken up with text and how much room is taken up with media, okay? You got lots of pictures and you're in Outlook.com, you might be bumping up against that. You could look into the settings on your account, and it will tell you how close you are. Just open another account.
Yeah, that's what I said. Worst case scenario, just open another one, and or go through every single email and be like, okay, I don't want that anymore. I don't want that anymore. I don't really want any of these anymore.
But then you get Outlook or whoever it is. My daughter sometimes comes and looks at her emails online and closes it, and I bet you the next day it looks like somebody was on your computer doing this.
Yeah.
Yep.
And it will give you a message. Someone was on your computer and logged into.
Yeah, I think that's what it says. Yeah.
Yeah, and then there will be something about, was this okay? And if you say yes, you're fine. If you say no, it will lock your account.
Oh, I'm not doing that.
Yeah.
Will it lock her account, though?
No, well, it might.
Oh.
It might, but it will for sure lock yours.
Like, even Google, like, it's very fine print that you can't see it, but at the bottom here, underneath 15 gigs, open in one other location, and you can look at the details for that. This is his Gmail, anyways. I can pretty much guess what the other location is either his phone, phone or tablet, one of the two. I've had, like, I wouldn't worry too much about any message that says, someone tried to get into your email account. Because the key word there is tried. They didn't do it. I've had like a couple messages just say, oh, from China. I'm like, I don't have nothing on my email anyways. They can look.
James is right there in that the wording is very important. Someone attempted to enter your email from Uzbekistan. The word attempted is what you're looking at. Attempted means they didn't succeed. A closer read might say someone opened your email in Uzbekistan. Was this okay? No. And it will ask you to change your password right away. If you don't, the next time you try and log in, you got to go through big schlamazel to recover that password to something that's yours and not theirs.
Yeah.
That's what I had to do through that Facebook.
That's right. That's
because
right.
I wasn't even in Facebook, and then, like I said, it was already in the house when it started. And now I got it all. I took everything out of that just to deactivate it. But if I go back in now, nothing's in there now.
Yeah.
I put nothing in there. I'm just watching to see if something sneaks back in. This is on your webmails, of course, but would you get that on the local, like, source, the little source thing? Did they tell you?
No.
No,
you won't get that from local mail. Now, it all depends. Remember that you can log into source through the web.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be local to your computer. Yeah. And when we say local, what we're talking about is something like
Windows Live Essentials.
Windows Essentials, Live Mail.
Outlook Express from good old XP.
Yeah. All of those local email clients. Okay?
Can I ask a basic question?
Sure.
Wife went shopping at Hudson Bay. So somehow she must have given them our email. Every day I get five or six special at Hudson Bay. How can I wipe out Hudson Bay from people?
Block it.
Go to the bottom of the page and unsubscribe.
Yeah, there might be an unsubscribe button there. From a reputable company, they will allow you to unsubscribe.
Sort of. It's a bit of a hassle even with actual companies. I could show you how to do it, but he doesn't have anything that's spam other than this goddamn Amazon thing, which I'm pretty sure he doesn't want it to be spam. So I can't really show it.
Is there any reason why I've never used anything else but Outlook, and a long, long time ago I got a Yahoo address to sell something on Kijiji. Is there any reason why Google, as I've heard you say, is better than Outlook? What makes it better?
Most email addresses have to just go with preference. We just prefer Gmail. It can be better. It just depends on what your preference is, really. As far as like I know, Google, you can like organize it to the point where Outlook can't organize it. Like, he's made this so it's blue and all this, and added social promotions, updates, so everything's organized to the point where you can find anything and everything without trying that hard.
The reason I've organized it this way is that there are certain things that I want to look at on a daily basis, and I don't want to be going through a lot of crapola to get to them.
What has Trump tweeted today?
Goes to social and promotions.
But how does
the good
Google
stuff
know?
Goes to Frank.
How does Google know what's there?
I've told
him.
In the background, under this little gear wheel here, for settings, okay, are a lot of settings to tell Gmail how you would prefer that it handles every kind of mail.
But yet,
not very much. This is highly customizable. This is highly customizable. That's why we use it.
But yet, you can't get my email to come out of trash. Have you put it in trash so many times?
No.
Google's just like, okay, you don't want anything from him.
Yeah, it's every time he sends me money, I have to go to the trash looking for it. Because Gmail has decided that whatever James sends me from a bank is trash.
Okay.
So every time he sends me money,
he's like, "You didn't send me money."
He has to send me a text so I know it's in trash, so I can get it out of there before it disappears.
It'll disappear on you.
Yeah, it'll disappear.
Trash will empty every 30 days.
Something like that.
Like the basic level, you can't set it up so it empties like every day.
This is the email trash.
Yeah.
Not the regular trash.
Yeah. Okay, one thing that I wanted to get to just a second or two before we finish this up is I know I have said a lot about Windows Live Mail, and the one thing I'm going to say about it right now is I'm no longer recommending it for anything.
We hate Windows.
Yeah. Yeah. There, Microsoft is not supporting Windows Live Mail like they should be. It's not keeping up with technology. That's why you're having a lot of trouble with it with Source. And now that Source is Rogers, there's even more trouble. Okay? It's not sending stuff. It's not receiving stuff. It's having trouble finding servers and stuff like that. That is a problem, and I've asked Source about this, and their techs have told me that's a problem with Windows Live Mail. Okay, if you want to have a local email client, Thunderbird is the way to go. It is so simple and so easy to use. If you're going to set it up with your Outlook account, your Hotmail account or whatever, it's IMAP, okay? If it's a local server like Source, it's PopMail. You can check with PopMail with Source to see if they will do IMAP. I think they do. The thing about Thunderbird is that they're updating it constantly with all of the email providers out there. So when you put in your email address and your password and say create an account, Thunderbird automatically goes through everything it knows about Outlook, Gmail, Source Cable, Rogers, any email company that you can name, and it already has the configuration for those email services. It just puts them in automatically, and in 2 minutes you're up and running.
So this,
you can unload it from the computer, but I wouldn't do that right away. If you're going to use Thunderbird for mail, and you're not going to use Windows Live anymore, first off, get Thunderbird working. Get it working first, that email is coming in and coming out properly, that you can get your addresses into it, okay, because you'll have to export them from Windows Live Mail to import them into Thunderbird. And once you've got everything working the way you want it in Thunderbird, then rather than make Windows Live Mail go away, just go in and take out the account, okay? Just tell it, no more account in here. It won't make the mail go away, just the account. So if you want to have the mail saved in there, if you've got mail saved for 2 or 3 years, and you don't want to lose it, just take the email account out. And it will put that mail archived. Okay?
It doesn't
hurt.
I took mine right off.
Yeah.
The Windows Live Mail, I took it right off.
Yeah. If there's nothing in it that you want, you're perfectly good to do that. Yeah. But if you're using internet mail, web mail, that's the way to use.
You know what we should all learn about next week and the following weeks? Nothing but Linux.
No, we're not going to do that. Yes.
Google extensions. Remember I said
yes.
Go get Adobe Reader? Okay, and I didn't update it, right? I went through the Google extensions, and there is one there that's Adobe Reader, exactly the same thing and everything. Can I click on that?
Yes, you can.
On Adobe Air, I get one that says Adobe Air needs updates.
Yeah, Adobe Air is okay. Somehow or other, that's gotten put on your computer as part of a gaming site. That gaming site needs Adobe Air to work. Now, if you never go there anymore, but you don't know which one it is. So just keep updating. It's fine. Adobe Air is fine. All right, that's it for today, folks. Thanks so very much, and I'll get this up online as quickly as I can.
That's Computer Club Listen for today. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.